I just want to introduce you to my new girlfriend. Oh, wait, that's right. Yeah. I still don't have a girlfriend. So, one of the very hot topic news stories going around here in America is talking about the whole controversy over, excuse me if I'm mispronouncing the name, it's Manti Te'o. He's the linebacker for the University of Notre Dame that gained some national attention by, well, perpetuating this hoax that he had this girlfriend that was unfortunately killed in a car accident, but as it later turned out, the girlfriend was just a hoax, and that he made her up and had other people maybe allegedly. I don't know the whole, every little detail of the story, but that's the thing I want to talk to you about, not because I sort of, now that the truth has come out that this linebacker that garnished a little bit more notoriety through this made-up tragic event, maybe it just got out of hand and all the national news media covered it and wanted to feel bad for the guy, and he was, you know, supposedly playing through so much pain and anguish, and he was just, bitten, written about in all different kinds of articles. And now I kind of feel bad about for this guy. Maybe, maybe just got out of hand. I can't propose to get inside the guy's head or what motivated him to do something like that. Of course, I also have my other theories why, but we won't get into that. I just kind of feel bad for the guy. Now, what I'm really, really angry about is the national media that perpetuated it. The lazy, disgusting, politically agenda-driven national news media that, I don't want to say covered it up, but just, wanted this story to be true. Even through the tragic end that this poor guy that supposedly went through all this emotional anguish of the loss of this girlfriend on September 11th even. Reportedly this imaginary girlfriend had in a car, the way the story was written, from what I understand it, that she was supposedly killed in a car accident and went through the hospital and eventually succumbed to her injuries. And it just, why didn't anybody else check up on the facts? It's just like they took his word for it. They were so lazy. They wanted it to be true. I'm sure that they looked at the guy, and they saw his face, and he's not a Manti Te'o is not a Caucasian player, so I'm sure that it was politically motivated to perpetuate this story that here's a non-Caucasian that we can make a hero out of. He was going through the entire year. Notre Dame was undefeated, and he was playing in the national championship game. And they all wanted this guy's personal story to be true. So let this be a lesson. Do not trust the national media. This is another shining example of the lazy journalism. I'll come out and say yellow journalism. Maybe I'm misusing that term, but I sure call the all the four-letter network and everyone else that just passed it along and accepted it to be true without fact-checking when it took nationally renowned blogger to uncover most of the truth. And I think the days of national media are coming to an end. I mean, I used to work in the media. I used to work in a radio station and news talk formats, and I'm struggling to get back into working in the media. And when I see the, in a, from a, like a personal perspective, it's I'm so frustrated that all these people that have these cushy jobs in journalism, and they don't fact check, they don't do anything. They just write these glowing reports, and here I am struggling to make ends meet, and I could have done 20 times better, and I could have exposed this guy for the fraud that he is. But unfortunately, I'm just a blogger now, and I'm not in that little clique of news media. So that, I think that's what it really infuriates me more. Not that the guy lied, not that the guy played so many people for suckers, for whatever motivation he had. What makes me most angry about this is the national media perpetuated it. So that's been my little take here. Thanks for watching, everybody.